Hi, I hope that you're extremely good. On this lesson, I'm going to teach you inequalities. And I'll give you the definition as usual. What is an inequality? An inequality is a mathematical statement which shows that the right-hand side is not equal to the left-hand side. I'm going to repeat. An inequality is a mathematical statement which shows that the right-hand side is not equal to the left-hand side. The other thing that I want you to know, which is very crucial, is that we have two types of inequalities. We have got strict and not strict inequality. Meaning to say, if you have a mathematical statement that will be an inequality, it will be either a strict or a not strict inequality. Now, maybe you're having a question, what is a strict inequality? What is a not strict inequality? I'm going to clarify now. Let us start with strict inequality. What do we mean when you are saying a strict inequality? Strict inequality, there is only one concept that I want you to take note of that will help you to identify a strict inequality. A strict inequality has no possibility of equality. For instance, if I say your mother is greater than you, this is the greater than sign. There is no possibility of equality. There is no way that you can be greater than your mother, right? Then we can as well use the less than sign. I can say you are less than me. Yes, there is no way that you can be greater than your teacher, right? I am greater than you. This is the less than sign, right? I can say you are less than me, right? I'm saying you are less than me, not when it comes to age, when it comes to the mathematical knowledge. Anyway, I'm joking. Okay, so this is the greater than sign and this is the less than sign. A strict inequality has no possibility of equality. Let us look at a not strict inequality now. What do we mean when we are saying a not strict inequality? Not strict inequality is the exact opposite of a strict inequality. Remember, I told you that on a strict inequality, there is no possibility of equality. Now, on a not strict inequality, there is a possibility of equality. For instance, you can have this sign, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. There will be this equal sign down, then it will show you or it will tell you that this is a not strict inequality. Okay, many people, they always ask, how does this help me in life? We use mathematics each and every day. In most cases, you don't know that you are using mathematics, but you'll be using mathematics. Let me give you a good example. Let's say we are talking about a bus, a 65-seater, right? I'm going to use P to represent passengers. So this bus is a 65-seater, and this P is for passengers. This means passengers and number of passengers, right? So greater than or equal to. 65 is greater than or equal to the number of passengers. Meaning to say, the number of passengers, if there are more, there will be 65. So number of passengers will be, if you read it from this side, P is less than or equal to 65. Or 65 is greater than or equal to P. Right? You can use the same concept down here. P for passengers and 65 here. Same meaning. It means number of passengers or passengers less than or equal to 65. Meaning to say, if there are more, there will be 65. So you see that mathematics does apply in almost everything. There's no way that you can use mathematics in anything that you'll be doing. Right. Let me show you another concept. We can represent inequalities on a number line. In most exams, they like to ask you this. Represent 7 greater than x, like this. So if you want to rewrite this starting with x, you must make sure that your sign is open to the number or to the term that it was open to. So this is the same thing. It can be written like this, it can be written like that. So this means 7 is greater than x, or x is less than 7. Also, yeah, this means x is less than 7, or 7 is greater than x. What you should just know is that the side that it will be, let me use simple terms. The side that it will be open to, when I'm saying open like this, right? You see, it's open to 7 like this. Even here, it's open to 7. So the side that it will be open to, that is the side that will be bigger. So this means 7 is bigger. So how do you represent this on a number line? This is your number line or a number line. This is 7, right? In Africa, we don't say number line. We say number line. I'm joking. Right, so now, this is our number line. And 7 is greater than or x is less. So if x is less, which side is x less? Remember, this will be 6 and this will be 8. So x is less this direction and is greater the forward direction. So it will face this side. If it was like this, I'm going to give you another example, right? If it was like x greater than 10, just do the same thing. This is 10 and x is greater, so it's going to face the forward direction. This is how you represent a strict inequality on a number line. If it was a not strict inequality, there is only one thing that will change. Let's start with this one. If there is now an equal sign down, you just shade to indicate that it's a not strict inequality. Same applies here. If there was an equal sign here, you're going to shade this part to show that it's a not strict inequality. I hope that you benefited from this. If there is any question or any concept that you want to ask about inequalities or linear programming or any mathematical concept that you are struggling with, remember, I am here to help you and to make sure that you receive all the mathematical medicine you need if you are a mathematical patient. Okay, I'm trying to say, if there is any mathematical concept you are struggling with, feel free to tell me on the comment section. I'll clarify to you. Such that you pass mathematics with a distinction. That is my wish and prayer, for you to pass mathematics with a distinction. Remember, mathematics was not difficult, is not difficult, and it will never be difficult, even if only you stay focused. So you should stay focused.